Matthew's account of the birth of Christ is almost anticlimactic. After reading through the whole Old Testament, we have such an anticipation of the coming of the Messiah that we expect fireworks and parades. But that's not the way that Matthew tells the story. He starts with a genealogy. Now, if I was going to tell somebody about the birth of Christ, his genealogy would probably be the last thing that I start with. But we've got to remember that the birth of Jesus Christ isn't so much the beginning of God's story as it is the revealing of God's answer to our problems. The birth of Jesus is all about God showing that he is faithful, full of grace towards us, and sovereign throughout history. And Jesus' genealogy is a reminder of that as well. We find all sorts of people in the ancestry of Jesus. Some were kings, some were beggars, some were rich, some were poor. Some were generally faithful to God, and others were called wicked in the Bible. But each person has a story behind them, and each story reinforces the fact that a Savior was needed in the world. The ancestry of Jesus is there to remind us that we need a Savior, and that God is faithful to provide a Savior for us. Another reason why the birth of Jesus might seem anticlimactic to us is because those of us who are familiar with the story tend to lose wonder over the details. The circumstances of the birth of Jesus were unique. Mary was a virgin. The Holy Spirit had caused Mary to become pregnant. Such a thing had never happened before, and it never happened since, and will never happen again. And it happened to fulfill prophecy. While it would be impossible to point out every single time that Jesus fulfilled the Old Testament prophecies, since all of the Old Testament points to Jesus, then he fulfilled all of it. It's awesome to remember that even Christ's birth, something that he as a human being had no control over, happened at exactly the right time, in exactly the place, in exactly the way that God had announced that it would happen centuries earlier. And he did all this so that we could be sure that this was the Savior that he had promised to us, and that we could be saved through him. If we ever think that the birth of Jesus, or any part of God's story for that matter, seems dull or anticlimactic, it's only because we haven't dug deep enough, or meditated long enough how God had brought all this together for his glory and our good. So the question of the day is, how do you make sure that you don't lose your reverence and awe of God's story? As we begin the New Testament, realize that all of this happened because Jesus loves you, and it's written so that you might know him as Savior. God bless you, and see you tomorrow.